So we were studying steady one-dimensional compressible flow toward duct, and we have already considered two phenomenons. The first one was normal shock wave, the second one was Rayleigh flow. Now in this section, we will consider what is known as Fano flow. Fano flow is nothing but the flow with friction. The flow with friction. Consider this control volume. The properties of the fluid are changing along the duct, and this change in properties can be brought by three phenomena. We have considered two phenomena, normal shock wave and Rayleigh flow. In normal shock wave, the flow properties were changing due to discontinuity in the flow. Discontinuity means the pressure, temperature, density are changing suddenly. In Rayleigh flow, the properties of the fluid were changing due to heat transfer with the surroundings. And in Fano flow, these properties of the fluid will change due to the presence of friction force. Due to the presence of friction force. Now, we will first consider the difference between Fano flow and Rayleigh flow, and where we can apply Fano flow and where we can apply Rayleigh flow equations. So look at figure A. In figure A, you can see that the duct is short, and its cross-sectional area is large. So large cross-section, and in such cases, we know that wall friction, the friction between the fluid which is flowing at certain speed and the wall of the duct will be negligible. In this case, friction is negligible. And such cases happens, for example, in the cases of large nozzles. This large nozzle, for example, can be part of supersonic jet or say rocket engines. So in case A, the friction is negligible, but the properties at one and properties at two will be different because of heat transfer, between the fluid and the surroundings. And in case A, we will consider the flow as Rayleigh flow. Now look at figure B. In figure B, you can see that cross-sectional area is small, small cross-section area. And it's a long section. In this case, the friction force will be significant. Friction will be significant. And we cannot neglect friction forces. Though we may assume the flow is adiabatic, the friction will be significant. And in this case, we will consider the flow as Fano flow. Fano flow, and such case occurs, for example, in gas pipelines. In gas pipelines, so we have now understood what is Fano flow. The Fano flow is nothing but steady one-dimensional adiabatic flow through a constant area duct with significant friction effect. The flow is adiabatic, but the flow is with significant friction effect, and such flow is known as Fano flow. The inlet conditions, which is U1, P1, T1, rho 1, E1, are known to us, and we have to determine properties at outlet or state 2, and these properties can be found out from governing equations. So these are governing equations. The first one, as we all know, is continuity equation, which is rho 1 u1 equals rho 2 u2. The second equation is momentum equation. And since in the case of Fano flow, friction is present between the fluid flow and the wall of the duct, we cannot neglect friction force. We cannot neglect friction force, which is F friction. So our momentum equation will become P1 plus rho 1 u1 square equals P2 plus rho 2 u2 square plus F friction divided by area. And since friction is in the negative direction, we have to take friction on the right side. Now the third equation is energy equation. H1 plus u1 square by 2 equals H2 plus u2 square by 2. The fourth equation is of the equation of state, which is P equals rho RT, since we have considered our gas as an ideal gas. The fifth equation is true for calorically perfect gas, and which is H equals Cp into T, which is nothing but enthalpy is the function of temperature only. The sixth equation is of entropy change, which is S2 minus S1 equals Cp ln T2 by T1 minus R ln P2 by P1. Now to find out the solution of these equations, what we do is that we know inlet state, that means all the properties at 1 are known, and we have to determine exit properties, which is P2, T2, rho 2, E2 and U2, and for any specified value of F friction, obviously there is an infinite number of possible downstream state 2 corresponding to a given upstream state 1. But what we do is following. We assume various values of T2, we assume various values of T2 and calculate all other properties as well as F friction, and we plot TS diagram. And the plot of Fano flow on TS diagram is known as Fano line. Next we will consider Fano line. This is TS diagram. We have plot Fano flow on TS diagram, and such curve or such plot is known as Fano line. And we can make following observations. The first observation is that for any given initial state, the flow cannot exist at any downstream state outside the Fano line on a TS diagram. And in fact, Fano line is the locus of all possible downstream states corresponding to an initial state. The second observation we can make that friction causes entropy to increase. And thus, a process always proceeds to the right direction along the Fano line. The process will always proceed to the right direction, whether the flow is subsonic or whether the flow is supersonic. And at point A, the entropy is maximum. It is a point of maximum entropy. Point A, the entropy is maximum. And here, Mach number equals 1 occurs. All states on the upper arm of the Fano line represents subsonic flow, and all states on the lower arm represents supersonic flow. Now let us first consider subsonic flow. In subsonic flow, friction will increase Mach number. If the flow is subsonic, its Mach number will increase. During Fano flow, you can see that here the Mach number at 1 is less than 1, and we know that the process always proceeds to the right direction, and at point A Mach number equals 1. Hence we can say that in subsonic flow, Mach number always increases in a Fano flow, and the opposite is true for supersonic flow. Its Mach number will decrease. Here the Mach number is greater than 1, and at point A Mach number equals 1, and so we can say that in a supersonic fan of flow, the Mach number decreases. And in conclusion, we can say that friction tends to make the flow sonic. I'm repeating it again, friction always tends to make the flow sonic. And at this point, maximum entropy will be achieved. The fourth observation we can make that since the flow is adiabatic, we know that h plus u square by 2 equals constant. And we know that h equals Cp into T plus u square by 2 equal to constant. And we also know that this is equal to Cp into T naught, which is equal to constant. And we will assume that specific heat is constant. And from this equation, we can say that stagnation temperature will be constant throughout the flow. And hence, we can conclude that stagnation temperature remains constant throughout fan of flow. So next, we will consider the effect of fan of flow in static temperature T. We know that from this energy equation, T naught equals to T plus U square by 2 into Cp. Now, when the flow is subsonic, we know that its Mach number increases. And if Mach number increases, its velocity U will increase. And we know that in fan of flow, temperature T naught remains constant. And in a subsonic flow, U increases. That means the static temperature T should decrease in a subsonic fan of flow. Now, when we consider supersonic flow, we know that its Mach number M decreases and hence its velocity decreases. But since stagnation temperature does not change, from this equation we can say that its static temperature T will increase. So in a supersonic fan of flow, static temperature T increases. In subsonic flow, temperature decreases, and in supersonic fan of flow, static temperature T increases. Now we will consider the effect of fan of flow on density rho. From continuity equation, rho into U is constant. Now first we will consider subsonic fan of flow. We know that in subsonic fan of flow, its velocity U increases, and from continuity equation, density rho is inversely proportional to velocity. In subsonic fan of flow, density rho will decrease. And the opposite is true for supersonic flow, which means in supersonic flow, since its velocity U decreases, and from continuity equation, rho is inversely proportional to U, its density will increase. Next, we will consider the effect of fan of flow on static pressure P. Now, from the equation of state, we know that P equals rho into R into T. Now, when the flow is subsonic, we know that its density decreases, as well as its static temperature T also decreases. And from this equation of state, we can say that in subsonic flow, static pressure will also decrease. Now, when the flow is supersonic, we know that its density increases as well as its static temperature increases. And from the equation of state, we can conclude its static pressure P will increase. So static pressure in subsonic flow decreases and static pressure in supersonic fan of flow increases. Next, we will consider the effect of fan of flow on stagnation pressure P naught. We know very well that the effect of friction is to always decrease stagnation pressure. The effect of friction is to always decrease. Always decrease stagnation pressure regardless of whether the flow is subsonic or supersonic. But what was the effect of fan of flow on stagnation temperature? We have seen that friction has no effect on stagnation temperature. Why? Since the friction causes the mechanical energy to be converted to an equivalent amount of thermal energy. Mechanical energy converts into thermal energy. Hence, the overall energy remains constant. Hence, total or stagnation temperature does not change. Though static temperature T may change because of this conversion from mechanical energy to thermal energy, but its stagnation temperature T naught will always remain constant.